The following is a class on the Bhagavad Gita as it is, 7th chapter, text number 9, given by His Divine Grace, A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada, recorded on August 15th, 1974, in Vrindavan, India.
So Krishna is describing how he is praised everywhere. In detail. In the beginning, before this verse, he has mentioned in so many ways. So we can see Krishna in every step and every moment if we practice to see Krishna. It is not difficult. Whenever there is fragrance, just like rose flower, beauty and fragrance, you can immediately remember Krishna. Here is Krishna. Simply, we have to practice it. So, as soon as you remember Krishna, you say or utter the word Krishna, immediately Krishna is contacts you. You are in contact with Krishna immediately. And if you remain constantly in contact with Krishna by studying all these details, then where is the lack of Krishna consciousness? And if you remain always in that way, Krishna conscious, then you are the topmost yogi. Yogi namati sarvesham. Very easy. It is not at all difficult. Simply you have to practice. As soon as there is nice fragrance, nice flower, in another place, it is said that the nice flower or any flower that is fructified and that is blooming, that is mining of Krishna. You can see Krishna is mining as soon as you see a flower. So I do not know why they say, can you show me Krishna? Krishna is showing himself in so many ways. They will not tell you. It is not at all difficult to see Krishna every moment, in every state. If we study what Krishna says, this is Munnaganda Pratibhyan. Everything is there. Now, within the earth, every stalk is there. The flavor of rose flower is there, and the flavor of some other flower is also there. But you cannot take out by your so-called scientific chemical process. You take some lump of earth and extract from it the flavor of rose. It is there. There is a fact. Because you sow the seed of a rose flower, it will exact the rose flavor from the earth. That's a fact. Who can deny it? Otherwise, where from the flavor is coming? Krishna also, it is said, jivananda sarva-bhuta guru. It is life, seed, bijam, next verse he will say, bijam sarva-bhutam. Bija, the seed. The seed is so nicely made by Krishna's brain that as soon as you put on the seed within the earth and put some water, it will come out, fructify and gradually grow and exact the flavor, the color, everything. This is a fact, no, everybody knows. Not only that, a small seed a banyan tree, Bijam Sarvabhutana. There is also Krishna. Otherwise, how this wonderful thing can happen? A small seed, just like a mustard seed, and it not only one tree, but many millions of fruits, and in each fruit, many millions of trees. This is Krishna's brain. You cannot do that. The so-called manufacturers, they can manufacture one watch very complicated, but not that, from that watch, many watches will come. No, that is not. But Krishna is so powerful, omnipotent, that he has manifested, because he is there. Bijoham Sarvabhutam. Whenever he is there, he can play wonderful things. This is study of Krishna consciousness. What is the difficult? Bija, Punnaganda Pratigmancha, Tejas Chasmi Vibhav. Now this electric lamp, it is brilliant. It has got some heat, temperature. Where from it is coming? It is coming from Krishna. That's a fact. Cause of all causes. Ishara Parama Krishna Satchidananda Vigraha Anadiradi Govinda Sarvakarana Kala. This is a fact. These are explained here. Everything that is there. Janmadrasya Jata. But we should not, like Mayavadi, we should not make mistake, because the electric bulb or electric light is being caused by Krishna, therefore the electric lamp is Krishna. No, not that. Krishna always separate from the electric lamp. The Mayavadi says that because Krishna is there in the electric lamp, or in the tree, or in the seed, or in the color, or in the flavor, therefore Krishna is finished. There is no more Krishna, because Krishna has spread himself in so many ways, then Krishna is finished. This is finished. It's like you take a piece of paper and make it small fragments and throw it, then the original paper is lost. This is material. But Krishna is not like that. Krishna is a person, and from his energy, so many varieties of productions are coming out, but still he is existing. Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnameva Vishnu. He is Purna. Not that because so many things have been taken from Krishna, Krishna is finished. This is materialized. They cannot conceive of the omnipotence. They accept God is omnipotent. But they cannot understand what is that omnipotence. The omnipotency is that so many things are being manifested by the Krishna's energies, but Krishna is not Lord. Krishna is there. We haven't got to worship so many things. Pantheism. No. That is not our. Pantheism, the same idea, that Krishna or the Absolute Truth has become divided into so many ways. Therefore, everything combined together is the Absolute Truth. This is the theory of pantheism. But ours is Vedic proposition that Krishna is the cause of everything, varieties of material and spiritual things are there, but it's Krishna's identity is there in Vrindavan. Vrindavanam parityajya padam ekam navacchami. Krishna is there. Akhilatma bhuta goloka eva nivasati akhilatma. That is stated गोलोकनारने निधाम तलेत देवी महेश हरिधाम सुतेषु तेषु ते प्रभाव निशया विहितास्तेन गोविंद मान गुरु संतव अद्वैत अच्युत अनंत रूपम आद्यम पुराण पुरुषम नवजौवन च वेदेश दुर्लभ अदुर्लभ आत्मभक्तो दीज फीचर्स ऑफ कृष्णा हाउ ही साइमल्टेनियसली वन एंड डिफरेंट अत्यंत हिलार कृष्णा इज दिस इलेक्ट्रिक मैन एंड स्टिल ही इज नॉट द इलेक्ट्रिक मैन कृष्णा इज दिस हीरो बट इज नॉट द हीरो When you say that Krishna is everything, therefore just like some big mission they say, anything we accept as God, it is all right. No, we do not say that. Neither Krishna says. When Krishna speaks of worshipping, he does not say that he worships the electric light or something else. Mamekam. That is Jesus. Not that Krishna has become everything, therefore everything has to be worshipped. No. This is wrong. This is Asinta Bhila. You have to take shelter of Krishna, personality. Mamekam Sarvam. Not this, that I. You have to understand that varieties are dependent on Krishna. But not that because there are varieties, that what Krishna is finished. No, that is not it. Philosophy. Jivanam sarva bhutesu tapasyatmi tapasyasu. Specially, tapasi. Tapasi means those who are seeking after eternal happiness. Karmi, yogi, there are many tapasvi. But real tapasvi, tapo dibbam, that is, dibbam means transcendental. Just perform tapasya for realizing Krishna. Tapo dibbam. Otherwise, Hiranyakashipu, he also performed tapasya. What was that tapasya? He performed severe tapasya, so much so that the whole universe became perturbed and Brahmaji came to see what he wants. Now, I am performing tapasya for becoming immortal. So, if you make me immortal, it will be very kind of you. He said, I am myself not immortal. How can I make him immortal? That is not possible. So the idea is, he also performed tapasya, but that tapasya was for material gain. But that is not tapasya. Tapasya means to undergo voluntarily some inconveniences of this body, because you are accustomed to enjoy bodily senses, and tapasya means voluntarily to give up the idea of sense gratification, and that is tapasya. Tapasya, just like Ekadashi. Ekadashi, one day fasting, fortnight. There is also tapasya. Or fasting in some other auspicious day. That tapasya is good, even for health. And what to speak of advancing Krishna consciousness. So we should accept this tapasya. The upavas, there are many prescribed days for fasting. We should observe. And the preliminary tapasya, no illicit sex, no gambling, no intoxication, no meat eating. There may be some inconvenience to those who are accustomed to this practice, but we will have to accept it. Suppose it bong, putraka jena suddheta satya. If we want to purify our existence, At the present moment, our existence is not purified, impure. Therefore we are suffering. Just like when one's physiological condition becomes infected, he suffers from fever or other symptoms of disease. Similarly, we are suffering in this material world on account of this material body. If we want really happiness, then we must accept tapasya. Tapasya is required. Without tapasya, if you think that very easily, or without tapasya I can get it simply by imagination, then you become sahajya. To take things very easy. No, tapasya. Therefore Krishna says that tapasya asmi tapasya. That acceptance of tapasya means that tapasya is itself Krishna. You associate with Krishna. When you voluntarily give up meat eating or intoxication, this giving up, this process is Krishna. Krishna says, tapasya asmi tapasya. This is tapasya. Tapasya means to accept voluntarily something as enjoined in the Shastra. Shastra says, Krishna says, whatever Krishna says, that is Shastra. What is Ved? Ved means what Krishna says, that is Ved. There is none of Ved. That's like in the Srimad Bhagavatam it is said, Tene Brahma Rida. Brahma Rida. Brahma means Ved. Brahma, Sabda Brahma. So, Krishna Tene imparted, injected. Brahma, Vedi, Vedic Sabda. Sabda Brahma, Veda. Tene Brahma Rida to the heart. Krishna is situated in everyone's heart, so Brahma has no other spiritual master, but Krishna is there within the heart. Therefore Krishna's name is Chaitya Guru. Buddhijogam dadamitam. So Chaitya Guru, the Guru, Krishna is so kind. He is Guru within. And when we are serious, he manifests himself as a spiritual master. This is described in Chaitanya Charitamrita. So, Guru is helping from inside and from outside. Antar Bahi. Krishna is so kind. Therefore, Krishna manifests himself as spiritual master. Therefore, Vishwanath Chakravarti Thakur says, Sakshad Hari, Sakshad Hari Tena Samastha Shastri, manifestation of empowered, one who is pure, devotee, is empowered by Krishna to act as spiritual master. Therefore, spiritual master should be accepted, Sakshad Hari Tena Samastha Shastri. Rupta, it is described there. Tatha bhavata eva sadhi. Those who are learned, scholar, actual devotees, they accept. But that does not mean Guru is Krishna. Hindu prabhuja priya eva. Then if you accept, you accept means you honor spiritual master Krishna, because he is representative. But not that Mahabharata philosophy, that Guru and Krishna is the same. This is simultaneously one and different. Hindu, Prabhuja Priyayava. He is as good as Krishna because he is very, very dear to Krishna. Why dear? Because he is preaching on behalf of Krishna. What Krishna wants, he is doing that. That's what he is. Krishna wants everyone. Sarva dharman puritasya mame kam saranam. The Guru's business is that. Krishna does not mean that he takes the position of Krishna. He simply teaches people that he who accepts Krishna, the Supreme Personality of God, he surrender and see, he always think of it. You always offer your obeisance. You become a pure devotee of Krishna. This is Guruji. It is not very difficult. Anyone who is sincere, he follows Krishna's instruction. And instructing others also to do that is acharya. Aponi achari prabhu jivere sikha. This is acharya. You behave yourself exactly as it is stated in the Shastra, as it is ordered by Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, as it is ordered by Krishna, aponi achari jivere sikha. And you teach all your disciples who come to you as your disciples, his name, this is acharya. So acharya, guru, representative, it is not difficult. Simply one has to become very, very sincere. One must undergo the simple tapasas as prescribed in the Shastra. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, yes. Hridastha. Aponi achari prabhu jivere. You are preaching also the glorification of chanting Hare Krishna by personal example. Therefore, he is accepted as guru. All the Vaishnavas, all the acharyas, Goswami, they act according and free. Therefore, they are acharyas. And Krishna says, acharya mang vijanya, nama manne to kardi. See, this has been instructed. So, the Krishna consciousness movement is there. It is very simple. There is no difficulty. We have to always manmanabhava madhakta. Now, for us, those who are materially attached, we cannot think 24 hours of Krishna. It is very pleasing. But because we are materially attached, we cannot do. Therefore, Krishna is prescribing that you see the varieties of this material world and try to remember. These are the varieties. Punna vandha prasidhyancha, these sarni vibhavato. You study, nature study. Just like we study, nature study. Similarly, you study nature and see these important points and there. It is very scientific. You study nature and pick up some point and Krishna says that this is I. Very difficult. This is Krishna consciousness. Drinking water, you remember Krishna. You see the light, remember Krishna. You see the flavor, aroma, a very nice flower, punna gandha, immediately remember. Right. It is not the thing. Actually, we have to think of Krishna. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama. Always thinking of Krishna, manmana bhavma bhakta. Here is Krishna's form. Therefore, we have to worship deity. Constantly, if we worship, then Krishna's form is always impressed. I can see Krishna any time. If I close my eyes, I will see Krishna. Hare Krishna is nicely dressed. I see Krishna is very pleasingly eating, but I am prepared with devotion, bhaktya. Real thing is bhaktya, not official. Not official. Patram pushpam phalam toyam jomi bhakta apagatya. He does not accept anything. Even it is not offered with bhakti and by the bhakta. He does not accept. Why he selected? Is he hungry like me? No. He simply wants to see how you have learned to love Krishna, bhakti. how you are eager to serve Krishna. That is Krishna wants to see. Otherwise, he does not require your service. Lakshmi sahasra sata sammama sevvaman. He is always being served by hundreds and thousands of goddess of fortune. They are so much afraid that goddess of, we are praying here, goddess of fortune. My mother, goddess of fortune, give me some fortune. They are, the goddess of fortune is afraid if Krishna may reject. That's why Rukmini, when Krishna was joking with her, if she thought, maybe Krishna is going to leave me, immediately fainted. Immediately fainted. That is the goddess of fortune. So humbly, so fearfully, they are engaged in Krishna's service. What Krishna's service we can do? What we are? We are nothing. Insignificant. So, why Krishna accepts our service? Why he comes in his Akshamurti to accept our service? Just to induce you how to serve him. Bhakti. That is one. Therefore he says, say you give me even patram pushpam phalam tuyam. Doesn't matter. But give me bhakti. Jumi bhakya pujacchati. This is real. If you have no bhakti, if you officially met, Krishna does not touch you. Krishna is not so poor. Lakshmi sahasra sata sammama sevvaman. Govinda madi purusham. So whatever you do, you should always be humble. Krishna, I am quite unfeeling. So, whatever I could collect with my capacity, kindly accept. This is our only. Otherwise, don't be proud that I am doing so much for Krishna. Krishna will be obliged to accept it. It is not like that. Sinaga Vishuni Chena Tarorapi Sahishnana. This is one. So, it is very easy, very sublime. But you have to learn. And learning is also not very difficult. Here is everything, variety. You always think of Krishna and Krishna giving Buddhi Yogam Gadami, some. Tesham Nittari Yukkala Vajatam Sita Buddha. Tesham Nittari Yuvan, who is always thinking of Krishna. Here is Krishna, here is Krishna, here is Krishna. Nitta Abhi Yukkala. Tesham Nittari Yukkala. Krishna, you cannot see Krishna. That is not possible. Krishna is within your heart, he is seeing everything. Your intention, your purpose, your activities, everything. Upadrashta, only Bhagavad Gita is Upadrashta, Anumantya. He is witness. You cannot see Krishna. Be sincere and try to serve him. He will accept your service. And you give intelligence, your life will be successful. Thank you very much.